Hey YouTube, how's it going? And welcome back to The Long Dark. In today's video, we're diving back into Interloper. Last time, despite our incredible luck, the game got the best of us and we succumbed to the cold. But today, we're determined to get a real run started, and let me tell you, it feels great. I hope you enjoy the video. If you do, please drop a like. It helps me out very, very much. And with the intro out of the way, let's get started. All right. This looks like Muskeg to me. I have a feeling it's Muskeg. It is. All right, that's pretty lucky, actually. It's one of the... out of all the regions I don't know, Desolation Point and Muskeg are the ones I do. So, to score a start here, I'm going to run with it, because we had a hard enough time in... surviving in Desolation's Point. So, if I can get something I'm familiar with. I was really scared I was going to get Timberwolf Mountain or Ash Canyon. I'm not familiar with those spawns at all. Just trying to see if there's any cattails. Anything we can grab to eat. There should be plenty of them here. And yeah, I'm excited to kick off this run. Hopefully, this one goes better than the last one. Luck-wise, I'd love for us to keep up that luck, but not die this time. I think the reason I died, if you watched the last episode, or if you watched the last run, I think the reason I died is my clothes were probably wet. They tend to get wet. Trying to see where we are. They tend to get wet. Oh, that's not good. If you fall through the ice. I think this is by Spence's farm. I think I'm actually on the south side of the map here. Oh, maybe not. I don't know. There's the... back in the... off in the distance is the power lines. I really... if we can make it to Spence's farm, that would be cool. I don't know how the wolves are going to be, though. They are a big concern in this area. Yeah, there's one right there. Yeah, I think that's Spence's farm over there. Which means we're in bear territory, as we see the bear right there. And I don't know if I can... I think I can cross this. I'd just be careful. Nope. Not the best place to be, in between a bear and a wolf. Alright. We're going to want to keep our distance from this bear. And I think head around the outskirts here. Try to get into the back. I really would like... can I go up there? I would like to go over to Spence's. At least there we could get some safety. Up there. Let me see if I can get up here. Maybe we can kind of billy goat around and get somewhere safe. Not looking like it though. Oh, come on. Yeah, I don't remember. I don't know if I've ever been on this side of the ice. So I'm not quite sure how to get across. But we'll figure it out. But yes, I believe when the snow, even if it's like a flurry like this. See, our clothes are starting to get wet. I think that's what ended up doing us in last run. Even though I was fed and hydrated, the clothes were wet, and so we were fighting off the hyperthermia, which lowered our condition, and ultimately ended up, I think, killing... I think that's what killed us. So we're gonna try not to do that again. I'm gonna be a little bit more... I think I kind of learned my lesson not to be as stringent with the matches. Like, fire is our friend. We want to be as... we don't want to be wasteful, but we also don't want to end our run because we're being too conservative. It's a cool little spot. I hate the fact that my my vision's blurry because I sprained my wrist or ankle or whatever. But try to get out of here. Hopefully, we're not going to see any wolves. on our way over. The bear cave should be over this way. We can search there. There might be like a backpack or something in there. I guess we'll see. And yeah, Muskeg's not a bad start. I'm not upset about it. I'm gonna be if we get eaten. But for now, I'll take a Muskeg spawn. Even though we're freezing. It's actually not as cold as it usually is. I don't know if we want to go. I think we probably want to go to Mystery Lake. I think that's probably the best move. The region we're most familiar with. It's probably the easiest one to survive in. We do got to go the complete opposite direction. I think I missed the bear cave too. We obviously have to go the complete opposite direction. But something we may be able to do is we might be able to find enough scrap around here that we don't need to get the hacksaw right away. We might be able to get the axe and maybe even a knife so we could start getting prepared for the bow. Is that nothing? Okay. Take the cedar firewood. This is what I'm talking about. So there's scrap all along this, I hear footsteps, I think. There can be scrap all along these, the rail line here. So if we can find enough pieces, and I don't remember the quantity we need, but if we can find enough pieces, we may be able to head down to Spence's and take care of... And get the hatchet and knife crafted, or at least the hatchet, which means we won't, well, we still need the hacksaw, but which means we could then cut down the saplings we need, which means we can then cut down the saplings we need and start trying to craft the bow. The weather is picking up, which is not ideal. I'm watching Survivor Mike lately. Recently I've been watching Survivor Mike play, and man, like, he gets a start and he started his last Interloper run. I don't think he got a storm for like the first like couple hours, like real time hours. And me, I feel like I've been getting storms like the minute I start the game. We'll grab these cattails. This is where I need to eat. I'm going to keep following the rail line, and then we'll get to the car up here, and we're going to have to start a fire in there. I'm going to basically... Oh, we can't, unless we luck out and there's some matches. We're kind of screwed. We may just be trying to beeline it over to Mystery Lake. I'm not going to pick up too much cattails, because I don't want to stick... I can't talk today. I don't want to sit in this weather forever. Come on. Get up back on the rail line here. Yeah, keep following this along and see if we can get to the rail cars, which we should be able to. Maybe we'll look out and there's a box of matches next to the fire barrel in there. And we'll be able to start a fire and warm up. We can hope, at least. Can't see a single thing. But the rail line's gonna help us. Gives us something to follow, at least. And yeah, I don't really have a plan, per se. Obviously, it's to survive more than 24 hours. But there's likely a bedroll, I think. It might be guaranteed in the camp office on Mystery Lake. So I would like to snag that. On Gunloper, we found a mag lens at Trapper's. So there's that potential as well. Is there any mushrooms on this log? No. Okay. I don't mind walking through the blizzard as long as I know where I'm going. I don't want to be walking aimlessly, but getting to the rail car's pretty easy. And it should be right here. Let's fingers crossed for some matches. We got the flare. I'm probably gonna end up using that flare. See anything else? What's that? Scrawled message. Made it this far. I left you some gear to find. Okay. Let's take it. Know where that is. Another piece of scrap. I don't really want to use this flare, but we're freezing. We're gonna have to. Let me know if you think that was silly, but I think fire's probably most important, especially during this blizzard. We want to get ourselves as warm as possible. If I can run out and get even just a few mushrooms to make a reishi or two to help us get to where we need to, like to, in terms of heat, that would be great. Throw that there for now. We're gonna add this. We'll add two of them, and I'm gonna get rid of this for the weight. All right, let's look at our clothing. Yeah, these gotta go. Drop, drop, and drop. We're still warming up. I want these to dry, though. And get those dry, too. And then let's get some water going. So we're sitting here anyways. Cook. All right, all right. Come on, come on. Not quite sure what else to do. Let's look at what we got. We don't have much. All right, I got 11 cattails. Couple sticks, couple feathers. Nothing really that we can do about it. Just try to warm up here. I'll do that by passing the time, I guess. And we'll take that, and we'll do another batch. And these are still wet. And how much does that have? That's almost dead. Bye. And I guess we'll wait. We'll pass the time again. 2 hours, 36 minutes. We'll pass that as well. Alright, we'll take it. Put this back on. Gonna take that off. I'm gonna take that just for now. Because I know me, and I'm gonna forget to take some torches. And that's gonna piss me off, because I'm not gonna have another way to light these fire. So, I got three. Let's try to do maybe five. Yeah, and one more. Alright. I don't have a way to light them, but if I can, when I'm done, with everything, like once the storm dies down, I'll light a torch out of here and go, and we'll take it with us on our way. I'm gonna grab some sticks here. Still in pain, hence the wobbliness. I don't need any more rocks. I don't really need these sticks either, but we're warm as it is. Man, we got right into the chaos. The game wasn't even trying to be nice to me. I don't really need that. Finish that up. Let's pass that too. Take it. Let's do another batch. I would like to put my shoes on, and I'd like to put my pants back on. I would like to go out and see if there's any mushrooms I can grab. I know I can go over here. There's a backpack. Let's search it. Empty. Alright, over here, nothing. I can eat the cattails. The food's not really a concern. I would like to find even just a couple mushrooms would enable me to another piece of coal. Make a tea or two so I could drink it on our trip. A granola bar, that's good finds. Can't complain about it. Yeah, I don't know where there's any potential. That kind of looks like a log out there. Is it? It is. Do you have anything for me? No dice. Alright. I'll head back. I don't want to venture too far because that's going to be the end of me. Anything over here? Just real quick. No. Alright. And we're back to freezing. Alright, how's our clothes? Alright, not too bad. Alright. 51 minutes. I'm gonna try to ride out this storm, I think, best I can. Oh, I didn't mean to drink that. Oh, that's fine. Gonna need to drink water eventually. 4%. Okay. Are you dry? That looks dry. 3%. Alright, and put that back on. Cool. 2% and 2%. Yeah, we're kind of just chilling here. There's not really much we can do about anything right now. How much water do we have? 0.39 gallons. Alright, that's dry and that's dry. I'm gonna put those back on too. And I guess we're gonna just kind of wait this out as best as we can. Oh, oops. It's getting dark. Hour and 21 minutes. I just need the storm to break. Give me a little bit of luck here. Let the storm break. Sounds like it might be one, two. Yes. I ain't even gonna mess with it. And boil that later. And our luck turns around. That's what I'm talking about. Oh, I just missed it. Alright. Goodbye. Let's go. And we're off to Mountain Town. Just kidding. We're off to Mystery Lake. It's cold. Why are we hypothermic? What is the problem? Oh, sprained wrist. That's what my condition's a problem with. All right, whatever. Well, we don't have too far to go. We'll deal with the condition loss. Got torches to deal with the wildlife. Should there be a problem? I could start a fire in the camp office if I need to. Or maybe I just go to Trapper's. Not sure. We'll see. I might just beeline it to Trapper's. Since we're going to be walking past that way first. No sense in really kind of going past Trapper's. To then come back around and go to... To go to the camp office and then come back to Trapper's later. Yeah, I think that's the move. Trapper's at least have a bed. It... Probably as a cooking pot, should we need it, and then all the fun stuff, like, trying to think, like, all the fun stuff, like, maybe a magnet lens, or hacksaw, or something of the sort. So we're heading there. It's cold, but really shouldn't have a problem getting there. And I'm not too worried. It is a beautiful night out, though. I'm gonna keep my eyes peeled too. Is it over here? It's hard to see in the dark. I think that's where the moose spawns in this area, in case we ever needed to get him. My antlered brethren, probably up there. But we're over here by the tunnel, and we're heading over into Mystery Lake. I can't complain about this start. I can't. We got some scrap already, and we're in an area we're familiar with. I mean, it's night already, which kind of stinks, but we survived our first blizzard. Things are looking up. The Forlorn Muskeg. Thought it was blizzarding here. Can it really do that? Let's grab these rose hips. It is snowing heavy over here. Isn't there like a box? More rose hips, but isn't there a box over here? I'm trying to watch my condition. Don't want to forget about it again. I thought there was like a metal box that we could harvest or loot, sorry. I don't know. I'll look maybe in the morning. I might have overlooked it, but I don't want to hang out too late. Hopefully there's no bears. The bear can be over near Trapper, so hopefully we don't run into him, but otherwise should be good. Just heard a rabbit. I'd hopefully... I'm trying to think of what I'd like to find, if any. I mean, I'd like to find some matches, to be honest, at Trapper's. But as far as tools, hacksaw wouldn't be terrible. It's probably the most useful, considering I can get the scrap right away and we can make our way down to Spence's and get the bow and arrow early. That's kind of the I think the most important thing we're gonna end up doing is getting the tools we need to do the bow and arrow. A piece of coal. It's interesting that can spawn out here. Starting that back up. There's a deer over there. Otherwise, it's quiet. Is that birch bark? Definitely want some of that. Yep, perfect. Grab some birch bark. And I probably need to grab more sticks as we're going along here. I'm just kind of keen to get inside. Get in bed. Hopefully it's warm. And I want to dry these clothes off. Just keeping my ears peeled too for anything around us. I hear the rabbits. They always sound like they're getting murdered. Come up over here. See how much wildlife's hanging out down at the homestead. Grab these sticks. Grab this stick too. Yeah, I'm not seeing anything. The bear's not around. Wolves sound like they're that way. Sounds a lot closer than I thought he was. I usually don't come down into the valley here. Usually go up and around. But why not? Let's kind of explore a little bit for us. I'm going to check over here on our way past. Not seeing anything of interest. Nothing. Not a single thing. Not even like a book. I hate that noise. They gotta like change that noise. Alright, we're heading up here now. We're home. We're at Trapper's. And let's see. Hopefully, something interesting inside. Keep an eye on this torch, too. Make sure it doesn't go out. Let's just go ahead and relight it now. It's warm in here, so that's good. Love it when it's warm. I grab this soda. Granola bar. There's a safe. There's a sewing kit under the workbench. Let's see. Got a whetstone. Nothing in the workbench. Pick up this book. Okay, mag lens. Cool. That's the second time in a row I found that mag lens there. So I'm going to keep track of that. Make sure it's not... I'm going to try to take mental note of that and see if maybe that's a guaranteed thing or if I've just been lucky twice in a row. And, let's see. We got Frontier Shooting Guide. Backpack. Alright, nothing in there. That's open. Check that shelf real quick. Let's see. Nothing in the locker. Anything in the first aid kit? No. Alright, cool. Let's get this fire going, I think. Not with the mag lens. Torch, not the birch bark. 80%? Yeah, let's go ahead. Let's start that up. I didn't realize how good the books were for starting fires. I'm going to be carrying a few more books, I think, this run. 80% early game is going to be helpful. I don't think that... I always usually leave the books because of the weight, but I think it might be worth it to try to carry some. Cool, we'll do that. Let's make more water. We'll boil the rest of this one. Pick that up again. Did I miss a cooking pot? Nope. All right, take the newspaper for now. And let's see here, just one more once through. All right. And I'm gonna go ahead and crack this safe real quick. 99.3 and 45. Burn that cash, I think. How much we got? Oh, yep, I'll take that. Let's go ahead and make some more. How's our clothes? Dry, perfect. Take torch. Cool. Let's go outside and just do a little pickup for some sticks. See if we can grab some more fuel for the fire or for ourselves. And I think we're going to get to sleep here pretty soon. Frostbite affliction is back. Harvest a little bit of old man's beard here. That one? I can. Alright, perfect. Let's see. No, don't put it out. Stop it. Bad torch. Right. Grabbing the rest of this old man's beard here. I feel like I'm crouching, but I'm not. Not seeing any sticks. Footprints? Where are the sticks? Usually there's a couple by this branch. There's none. Like a cave, but it's not. Here's a stick, though. Okay. I can't believe I'm not finding any sticks. Want any more old man's beard? Take it. Last one. All right, and let's see, any other sticks around? Another branch. I really don't want to break the branches up. All right, let's go home. We'll, I think what we'll do is finish off this water. Restock on some torches. And we'll get some sleep. It would be nice if, it would be nice, I guess, if I could have been able to start another fire tomorrow. Let's see how we doing on sticks. 8. I really don't want to do any more. I'm going to take a minute here to... Can we make a rose hip? Let's see if we can make the tea. Yes, we can. That takes 15 minutes. We got 50 minutes there and 7 minutes there. Add a few more sticks, I guess. Take it. I think that's it for now. Gonna go ahead and make the... Gonna go ahead and make the rose hips. Let's craft those up. Perfect, and 40 minutes. Just go ahead and cook the tea. Have it. All right, 12 minutes. Oops, 12 minutes till ready there. And 3 scrap now. And I want to break these down since we're sitting here doing nothing anyways. Harvest the stick. 2 minutes. And I'm going to probably... Got 30 minutes there. It's got 5 minutes till it's ready. I'm going to take it. I'm not going to sit there and heat it up. I'm going to grab this so we don't forget about it. We got 4 minutes left there, or 24 minutes left there. Let's take the torch, put it out. Take one more torch, put it out. And how many torches do we have? 7? That's plenty. Put that away. Let's get to the bed. I'm going to drink, and we're going to call it a night. All right. It is morning. Thirsty. Probably going to do the starvation trick while we're still hunting food and getting things going. I think that's probably the best move. It is probably cold. Let me grab this charcoal. Let's see, maybe we want to map. How cold is it? Pretty cold. And I'm gonna get wet. Let's get out of here. I don't want to sit here. This place is looted. I would need the sun to light another fire unless we find some matches. We can skirt around. Probably shouldn't have come down here. But we can skirt around to get over to... I'm trying to walk and talk and think. We can skirt around the edge here to get over to the lake. The lake's a good spot to be because at the very least we can explore the camp office. But if we don't explore the camp office, we could also make our way out to out on the lake and search all the little fishing huts. I don't want to walk through this whole cave, but there might be some coal here in the beginning. having a few extra pieces of coal would be good since we're right here. And then, are those rocks or coal? Those are rocks. And I think there's a body in here not too far. So maybe he's got something good on him too. It should be a little bit easier to see. I think if I'm remembering correctly, I did raise the brightness on the game a little bit. It's at like 125% instead of 100% brightness. So just like a 25% bump. But I feel like it's making it a little bit easier for you all to see on YouTube without me having to do anything like crazy in post that makes it all look weird. And then it's still like, if it's pitch black, it's still too dark for anybody to see, but it just helps a little bit, I think, with, you know, you got with viewership and helping you guys better see. It's obviously helping me see a little bit better as well. Like, I'm not needing anything to meander through this cave. But yeah, I think that's why, one of the reasons why it's a little bit easier. But I know in some circumstances I have walked into caves and it's just black. You can't see anything. So I'm already mostly through this cave, so we might as well just peruse through the whole thing, grab what we can, and move on from it. We probably won't come back through here unless we decide to head to Milton. And I'm not sure when I'm gonna want to do that. Just Milton's really not my favorite area. I don't think it's that fun going through all the buildings. Obviously, we found the hacksaw there last in Gunloper, so if we're stuck on getting a hacksaw, we can always check the Orca gas station. But for the most part, I don't really enjoy looting all the buildings that much, because there's generally not much stuff to find on Interloper in the cabinets. And I don't think it's all that fun probably to watch either. So I'm going to try to avoid Milton if I can. There's the exit. Seeing if there's anything further, and try not to walk outside. And I think that's it. Yeah, we're leaving cave. So let's head back, and then we're gonna head over to the camp office. Doing one more sweep through here, seeing if there's anything I overlooked. Just the branch here. We grabbed all the coal. I think that was a good move. I think this was a dead end. Yeah, it looks to be. So we want to head over this way and continue on. Should try to watch my sprint. Try not to use it too much. I checked back here. I think there was a piece of like cedar over here. Nothing. I think we're good. I'm going to try to walk the rest of the way and allow our stamina to regenerate. In case we need to run from a wolf on the way out. And I'm going to take a minute just to kind of let things reset. Because, yeah, we're not full yet. Hey, Dennis. I could take your hat. Piece of coal? No. Check and see. Matches I overlooked. I missed a bunch of stuff when we were looting Desolation Point the other day, so I think we're this way. So I wouldn't be surprised if I missed some more stuff. But we're trying. The exit, about three quarters of our stamina. We should be fine. Nice, beautiful day. I should probably start a fire and just make the torch with the mag lens. Come on, give me the stick. I think I might. Let me grab some sticks. Might as well start the fire and get a torch going. I don't know how long it's going to be clear and how long it's going to stay clear, so it wouldn't hurt. Mag lens, birch bark. Can use the cache, I could care less. Don't want to use the cedar firewood though. Hopefully this works. Come on, little fire. You can do it. I don't think if you put a gun in my head, I would be able to start a fire with a magnifying glass. Torch. That one out. I don't know why I'm taking... Oh, we should might as well just heat up, huh? Can I heat up here? Degrees. How cold is it? That's not how we check. Feels like 15 degrees. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't want to sit here. Let's go. I accomplished what I wanted to. We started the fire. We have enough torches to make it where we need to. Maybe instead of heading the outskirts, we're going to head inwards. We can hit maxes, and then we can hit the broken down, depleted, do I have stones? I do. Okay. Yep. Where's he going? He's scared, and it ain't of me. Okay, that was odd. Feeling I'm gonna be like searching this guy and... I'll grab the last feather. I have a feeling I'm gonna be searching this dude and then Baloo's gonna be heading down this way. Let's go. I'm gonna keep heading this way. I think that's a deer over there in the distance. I think if I go back this way towards that tree and then around the bend here, that's where the like broken down building is. I think the bear den's over here. Maybe I was wrong. I do want to kill a rabbit eventually. I think I'd like to get situated in camp office before we go hunting. I do want to grab some rabbits early and start getting the rabbit pelt, the rabbit guts, all that stuff. Get that the process started on curing them so we can get some rabbit skin, like gloves and the hat. There it is. It's down there. That's the building I was talking about. Let me check real quick on myself. Okay, hyperthermia is not too bad. Head down this way. I could start a fire there if I needed to. Sometimes there's wolves around here, so I just want to keep my eyes peeled. I don't know where the bear is or where he could be. So we just want to be mindful of him too. He's not scared of fire like the wolves are, so something to always pay attention to. Deadfall area. I always forget the name of this place. We got enough torch. Let's grab some of these mushrooms. This one. And it sounds like the wind's picking up a little bit. Not quite as fun. Yeah, it definitely seems like the wind's picking up. And anything in here? Matches? No. Cooking pot. Dang, no cooking pot either. Alright, we'll take that. Let's reset the torch. Oh, yep. Light her up. As much as I want to grab those, what the hell are they called? The rose hips. As much as I want to grab them, I don't want to be out here in the weather. So we're going to just kind of beeline it, grab some sticks along the way, and get to the camp office. There's some rose hips behind there anyways. If we want to grab them, we can. I'm going to try to grab these sticks, though. All right, so we found a mag lens already. We've already used it. I'm excited about that. That was, fire is always our biggest concern. So the fact that we have at least some means to start a fire and keep one going, that's good. It's not perfect. Obviously, we need daylight in order to start the fire. We need clear weather to start the fire. You can't start it on a cloudy day, so... it's not perfect, but it is doable. Like, we can kind of use the torches right now and daisy chain them to make sure we keep the fire running if we need to. And, it'll help us, you know, keep our mobility around. He's not gonna bother me. I'm not worried about him. I'm gonna grab some of these sticks, though. Forgot one. Alright, let's grab these sticks here. He should be fine. I don't think he's gonna mess with us too much. I head back over here. And cool. This torch ain't gonna last too much longer. And the weather's picking up. Can we get inside before it blows out? We can. Alright. I'm gonna throw this down and we're going to light another one real quick. And let's see, what do we got? Anything of use. We're warming up, so that's useful. Let's check this workbench. I see the fishing hook. We got another whetstone, gonna leave it. I'm gonna take the can for now. And let's see, fire starting book, that's gonna come in handy. Eventually we won't need tinder, we can drop all the cattail stuff. I'm gonna leave the stack of papers. Monitoring this, get some cooking oil. I was monitoring the torch health. I'll take the cooking skillet and the herbal tea. Anything, there's a cooking pot, that's good. That's usually always there. Let's see. Is the bedroll in here? Oh, no bedroll. It could be upstairs still. Let's see. Some food. Pork and beans. Another can. Yeah, we're going to need that can. We got some... We still have some... Come on. Jeez Louise, man. Give me the spray paint. Thank you. We still have some health on our torch, so I'm not too worried about it. Let's see. I'm all over the place today. Let's search the cabinet quick. I'm watching the torch. We'll reset it if we have to. And let's see. Head. All right. They're gonna get progressively worse and worse. Give me the salt. Put it up here. Anything of interest over here? Another can. I don't think I need four of them. All right, and let's check upstairs. Nobody. It's fine. Another book. And bedroll, perfect. Cool, let's go ahead and start a fire with the torch. That right there, 80%. Hopefully the torch holds out. It doesn't sound like it wants to. I'm gambling here. Oh yeah, we have plenty of time. Put that out. Cool. Let's add some fuel here. I'm gonna add that to. Yeah, let's go ahead and drop these. Pick that can up for now. I'm gonna make my little collection like normal. But let's go ahead and open the inventory. Let's go to fuel and let's drop all of them. And let's go over here and we'll drop all of these. And what do we got? 8 tinder. We don't need 8 tinder. Drop 4 of them. That's going right now. Let's go ahead and basically just cook away. Let's just make as much water as we can. There we go. So we'll just keep those going. We got 2 hours of fuel. Let's search the rest of the building. Crunchy stuff. Anything else over here? Would like to find some matches. Read that note in a second. Should have read it before. Grab that. Let's drop both of these. Eat them. Let's search this drawer. Cool. Nothing. Got love when there's nothing in the drawers. Alright, and let's see. What was that note that we just found? Where are the notes kept? Notes. This one? You won't remember me, but okay. There's the note that I missed. This was, I think, the other one, right? No. Okay. There you go. Alright, so 1 hour and 46 minutes there. Good, we're good. Water's going. I'm gonna drink. Since we've got so much water cooking right now. Where's a good place to keep the water? But we're gonna keep it here. We're close, right? Here, I guess. Keep that. But the cans, what is it here? Campcraft? Yep. I love putting them over here. I don't know why. And the one back there too. And I think that's it, right? I think I want to keep one at least. Yeah, so we can drop this. Pick that up there. Put it there. Alright, that's 4 minutes till melted, and that's 33 minutes till melted. Go do another once over downstairs. Actually, let's drop. Actually, no, I like doing it by the front door. Let's drop the bedroll. Perfect. What's our weight at? We're good on weight. I got a couple pieces of charcoal. We're good on torches. Six minutes till boiled, 25 minutes till melted. All right, let's now. Go ahead and add that. And then let's go ahead and take a torch. Cool. And I want to go outside briefly. Want to make sure. I want to check around the building. There's a metal container back here. Should be. Yep. We're going to check that out. Nothing. And let's grab these rose hips. I am tempted to run down to the lake there and see what's in the fishing huts. Whether I do it or not, I don't know, but I'm gonna grab some cattails quick. It doesn't seem like the weather's gonna hold out very long. I don't want to go too far from those fires either, as I don't want to go too far from the fire because the water's boiling as well. But we can grab these cattails since we're right here. Making sure we have enough food is going to do us some good. I got a little bit more time on this torch. Checking over here. I think I have... I need a couple more stones. I think I had two. Four is probably good. Torch is getting low. Is there a cattail over here? No. Let's see. Light this back up. It might blow out here. If it does, it does. Not too concerned about it. We're right here. Though I say that, and it'll probably blow out, and then as I go up that hill, I'll get mauled. I take those, and we'll take this. Alright, we've been gone for a few minutes. It's probably worth heading back. Let's check, make sure the water's not boiling. It's probably ready. I don't think it's boiled over yet, but it's probably ready. We head inside, do one more once over to make sure we didn't miss anything. And then I think we need to just check our gear, make sure everything's sewed up. Grab some, I'll grab that cloth there and maybe do some repair work on our clothes. Checking underneath the cabinets again, or the shelves. Yeah, like I miss this potato. Alright, we could actually cook, I think, a baked potato too. Not a bad idea. I don't know if we need the oil for that. I'll take it, just in case. And I'll grab the salt. It's here as well. I haven't looked into the recipe for the baked potatoes yet, so I would like to, I figure I'll check it out, and if we can make it, we'll make it. And let's check the, just gonna let that go out. We got an hour there. Okay, this is done. And can we cook the potato? 48 minutes. Takes a little while. Yeah, but we should do it. I'm gonna add this fuel. Yeah, that'll be fine. Cool. And I'll break this down too. Alright, so let's go ahead and harvest this. It's almost nighttime again. I'm not even halfway tired though. We'll harvest this. And what else we got? I wanted to look at these rose hips. That takes, what, 15 minutes? So we'll do that. And then I'll check the water. Make sure that that's fine. I can't make any more anyways. 10 minutes until boiled, 22 minutes till ready. I did see we had some reishis. They take 15 minutes to prepare too. So this will boil that water over and get close for that baked potato being done. Cool, that's done, take it. And can we cook this other potato? Yeah, let's cook that. We'll pass the time till this is ready. Take it. I wonder if I can heat that up. Let's cook, can we cook the... Yeah, let's cook these teas. Perfect. That. And I'm going to go ahead and prepare another one. No, I'm not, because we're done. We're out. Cool. Let's take a look at our clothes. 39%, 97, 95, and 69. So we're going to want to... That takes 15 minutes. This is ready in 5 minutes. Gonna go ahead and make this. All right, and we're going to break this down by hand. That'll make the tea ready. Take it. This is still going. I should have just cooked the potato in the skillet. Takes the same amount of time, but this one makes double the water. That's fine. All right, let's maybe sew our clothes. Go ahead and repair this. I didn't look at the time. Hopefully that didn't say an hour. It did, and I let the freaking fire burn out. Damn it. Should have checked. Well, there goes that. At least this is cooked. Stinks. How much food does that give us? 250? I don't know if I should eat these too. I'm a little worried about them. I'm worried about all this food right here that's under 30%. Or calories too would be nice. Yeah, let's I'm gonna drop it. What were we looking at? This drop and this drop. I just don't wanna risk it. I'm bummed that I let this fire go out because we certainly could have been like reading at least. Alright, let's drink some water. And how much water do we have left? 78.78 gallons, okay. And let's eat one of these. I don't know if I can reheat it, so let's just heat it. Let's just eat it now. We'll at least get the warmth bonus as well. And I'm gonna go ahead and eat the rest of these stalks here. And I'm gonna call this another night as well. And I think tomorrow we're gonna head down to the lake and kind of see what we find down there. All right, it's morning here. I wasn't tired enough to make it through the night, so I did end up having to pass a bit of time. It is still cold out. I'm gonna use this, like, the morning hours here to try to research a little bit. Especially while I still have some calories to burn off. And just try to get things, you know, keep things moving, keep our research up. Let me check my water. I want to take that half a gallon. How are we doing on weight? At 30 pounds? Okay. I do have the bedroll on me because I was going to maybe make an attempt last night to go out. I am going to drop that back off though. That'll cut down some weight there. And maybe we can light another fire out here with the mag lens. Nope. We're definitely not going to be able to do that. Alright, it's cold. It's foggy. Hear the woodpecker. Let's just scan the lake and just see if there's any potential. If there's any potential wolves out here. I like this for a screenshot. Might use that as the thumbnail. Who knows? Not seeing any wolves, which is preferable. I hear them howling, which mean, and they sound like they're that way, so we might be okay. I'm gonna take a look over here for any cattails. We wanna make sure we grab all the cattails we can. Music's picking up, I hate it. Please don't do it. And I don't see anything. Yeah, I'm not seeing any cattails. I'm not seeing any wildlife on the ice either, which is great, to be honest. I am hoping for at least a pack of matches in one of these huts or one of these buildings. But we're gonna probably search them all here. And then we can always, like, sleep or heat up, warm up in one of the like outmost buildings on the perimeter. Wood. Anything in this container? I'm gonna leave the newspaper. We're back to hyperthermia. Fun. I'll take the cloth. And anything in this plastic container? No. I'm gonna take the charcoal. Don't know why. Don't know if I'm going to be... I'd like to map all the regions. And I'd like to do it on Interloper, to be honest. But it's definitely not a priority. There's a cattail over there. But I'm not gonna get... It's not a priority for me, but it is something I would like to do. Just keeping my eyes peeled for any wolves. Back there, it looks like there's one or two of them walking around. Shut the door. Anything in here? I guess I'll take the firewood. I don't know why I would leave it in here. And with the newspaper. Eat it. Nothing in the top drawer. Anything in the bottom drawer? No. Practical gunsmithing. We'll take it to burn it. I will leave the charcoal. We've got plenty. So there's three wolves over there. And hopefully that means that there's zero wolves over by those buildings. In which case, that's the plan. We're going to head over there and try to loot them. Hopefully find at least one packet of matches. And any other tools would be great. But the matches are kind of the one thing I'd like right now. We're on the western access to Mystery Lake. Okay. I know that I've never been that way. It's not going to be today either, but that is a direction I've never actually traveled down. Keeping my eyes peeled for anything. Alright, so we have the affliction risk. I know there's a cave up there. I don't know if anything... Do any bears spawn in that cave? Or is it just like a cave? I should go up and check it out. Alright. On the docks, nothing. Bench. Oh, interesting. I didn't know you could break that down. Running. Bye. They can get on the porch. So we gotta be cautious. Oh, thank you. Take that. I forgot about clothes. I'm talking about all the tools we want. Some clothes would be nice. I'm gonna take a few of these books. I don't think I'll take all of them, but having a few books on me help us start those fires when we need them. Good time. Okay, nothing. Anything in the backpack? Nope. Can't break that down. Nothing in the crate. Nothing on the shelves. Nothing under the bed. Nothing under the chair. Nothing next to the chair. These shelves are clear. Back here's clear. We've searched all of the containers in this building. Would love to just chop this bucket up. And we're cold in here. Feels like 32. I'm gonna sleep an hour. That should warm us up. We didn't die, so I think it warmed us up. Okay, good. Healed. We are cold. Do I want to drink this soda? Yes, if I drink a soda, it gives me a few calories. It'll help keep our condition up. How warm is it out? It's cold. I could start a fire with the magnifying lens. Let's do it. Want to get a couple torches going. And there's wolves all around here, so having some torches would do us some good. I'm not worried about the cold. Dang it. And we'll try attempt number two. I just hope that while I'm starting this fire, a wolf doesn't come up behind me. I don't even know if you can cancel the animation. And I'm not gonna try. It's gonna be one of those things we find out in real time. We did get cold doing this fire, but let's go ahead and add that. Is that warming us up? Really, that's not warm. Well, I guess it might take a second. 10 degrees. What is our deal? Feels like 23. Feels like 24. Yeah, we're just cold, man. I probably shouldn't have used so much reclaimed wood, but we'll just eat this fire up. And it is what it is. It didn't cost us much to start it. Everything that we used is re renewable. 36. It's 25. And we get one more out of it. All right, go. We can grab some more sticks along the way in case we need them. I want to get to the other buildings. And we have plenty of torches that we can relight, so we can, as long as the wind holds out, we can daisy chain. But I do want to get over to these buildings, check out what we can find. Is that a body? No, that's a branch. Wolves are all over the ice. And there's a building here. Go inside, check it out. Should warm up a little bit in here. Yeah, gotta take the books again. And some clothes would be nice. Matches, thank you. That's what we wanted. Glad to have some matches finally. The magnifying lens is great, but being able to start a fire at night if we need to, or whenever we need to, is obviously preferable. Okay, nothing in either of these two containers. Check the medicine cabinet. Right, nothing. Nothing on the floor. Nothing here. I searched that. And nada, nada, nada. I don't want to sleep with this torch going. I want to keep this fire going, especially through while we're dealing with the wolves around the area, so it's gonna be what it's gonna be in terms of how cold we are. Have another note. Got a little bit more. Oh, you bitch. Give me that. Can I take that right there and put that there? Thank you. I guess we'll just relight another torch. I should probably use the older ones first, get them out of our inventory. Nothing in the metal container. Nothing on the shelf. Nothing in the crate. Those shelves are clear too. We got another soda here. And anything in the trash can. Negative. Nothing on the shelf, nothing under the shelf, nothing in the crate. Okay, nothing there in the cabinet either. And that's this room search. So we're getting out of here. And I think there was one more. Yeah, there's one more cabin. Wolves have cleared out of here. That's Great. Let's go inside. All right, we got a backpack. Okay, anything under the bed? No. Cardboard box? Nope. The crate? Nope. I'm gonna grab a couple more books, but I'm not gonna go crazy. How many books do we have? 8? That's plenty. I would love to take these, clear these shelves out, but I'm not gonna be dealing with that weight. Another book there. Let's check this metal container. We have plenty of light. Anything in the trash can? No. Alright, this kind of feels like a dud for a room. There's a lot of books, but nothing, like, immensely interesting. One more time. Anything in the crate that I can see? No. The cardboard box is empty as well. Alright, let's leave. We're fighting this cold. Do we head over to... I think we do. Head over to this fishing hut. And then that fishing hut and that building. And then we can head home. Looks like the wolves cleared out. We are cold, though. We should be okay, though, because we can get... we can restore our condition. Oh, that's good. I'm putting those on right now. Alright, cool. That's our hands and our head covered. Should help with some frostbite issues. And staving that off. We have enough... torch to get over to this this fishing hut, and then we're gonna check that building out, and yeah, I think then we're gonna head home and get the fire started there and continue to cook up some water and make sure all our needs are met, and then I think next time we'll go through the dam. I think we got a lot accomplished. We're off to a good start. It's nice to be off to a solid start and not be dead. There's still time though. I have a tendency to go a little rogue, and generally I usually feed myself to something, so there's still time. I could walk out this door and the bear's hanging out there. And it's, you know, we're feeding Baloo. But I think, too, that's the fourth piece of scrap. I'm going to do some math in between parts here and see about maybe heading back to Muskeg if we have the scrap to get a hatchet started. If we could get the hatchet started, we could start getting things prepped for the bow. I mean, the sooner we get the bow, the better. We can always go back and do the knife. It's something I never thought of before either. Like, as I'm getting more knowledgeable about the game, I always kind of like, for some reason, I had myself thinking, oh, you need the hacksaw in order to get the scrap. And then once you get the scrap, then you go to the forge and you scrap and you craft everything and you try to do it all at once. Forgetting that there are some places that just spawn scrap metal and then you can just take that there. And so that's kind of where I realized, like, oh wait, I could just go get the hatchet. At least make that part. Preferably, it would be great to just do everything all at once, but for how early we are in the run, getting the hatchet, if it's the only thing we're able to get, would be fine. Because after that, we can make the hatchet, and then we could use the hatchet to cut down the saplings, and then you have those be curing early enough so that way we can get the bow and arrow going as soon as possible. And then it's just playing the game, trying to get the clothes, trying to stay alive, and finding the remaining tools to then go make the knife and whatever else we need. Tell me if I'm wrong, though. Like, if I'm forgetting, like, hey, you need the knife to be able to do X, in order to, like, I don't know, make a rabbit skin gloves, right? Or whatever the rabbit gear is, like, you need, or deer, you need to be able to, I don't know, scrape the pelt with the knife to do it, like, so you can't craft it. Then let me know. We're gonna grab these cattails, I think, and try to get as many as we can. I should probably drop. Take a second and just. I do not need 15 of these. Drop 10 of them. And I think we can start just grabbing the stalks. Take it, leave it. Leave it. Leave it. Don't think I want to circle all the way around this little island. How much cattails we have? 16. Okay. Yeah, we're cold. We're at about 50%. It looks like even lower, like probably 45% condition as a deer. I want to get home. We accomplished everything I wanted to. We've got fire. We're in a good starting position. We're alive. I really can't complain about this start. As lucky as we were to have like three boxes of matches and stuff in the last run I tried, this seems to be a better position. I think, well, if only because we're alive. Because I'm thinking about it, we had some good gear. We had like not the combat boots, but we had trail boots. We found the three boxes of matches, the crowbar. Like we were pretty good. I had a bunch more clothing, I think. But it didn't pan out. You live and learn. This one, obviously, I'm much more attuned to how wet my clothing is. And paying, I haven't played for I think 3 weeks before I fired up that last run, so I just forgot all about my condition and was just so enthralled in looting and exploring and getting where we needed to go that I just oh, don't do that. I just went with it. I do want to check one thing here. It is midday. I'm thinking I take this torch here. How much torch do we have? I'm gonna just start another one just to be certain. Take this torch here. It's midday. I don't think I've done enough today. Let's go ahead and start this fire. I'm gonna heat up a little bit. I'm gonna warm a couple teas. And I think we're gonna head up to the forestry lookout and just check what's up there. If it's the heavy hammer. Because that's the thing I'm forgetting. We need the heavy hammer in order to craft at the forge. So we're gonna need to find that at least before we go. That's two failures at 80. Come on. I'm really glad I reset that torch. I'm gonna check the health of the torch after this fire if it doesn't take. It does sound like it's getting weaker. This one's looking golden though. All right, let's go ahead and reset this torch. And we'll try again. Now I'm regretting dropping all that that tinder. Cool, let's start this fire up. I want to put 5, I guess. Yeah, let's do those. Let's go ahead and throw. No, I don't want to do that. Let's. No. Let's cook this tea. Grab a couple of these. Put them in there. Can't believe I. Oh yeah, I did use some more of the stick. I'm like, I can't believe I don't have more sticks than that. That's got 22 minutes. Let's take this. Take this. That one's finishing up. I grab these. And then let's go ahead and harvest. While that's all going through, let's harvest these. Yeah, we're gonna put. Actually, I should have just plate down anyways. This one too. That one too. Do that little trick. Let's go ahead and start the water here. I'm not gonna finish it. This has got 11 minutes left. That's got 49 minutes. I'm gonna go ahead and harvest these other torches. All right, that's done. I'm gonna go ahead and do this one too. They're only 2 minutes. Nothing's gonna boil over. Okay, that's over. Take that. That's going. 38 minutes there. Make sure we don't burn these. Okay. And take a couple more of these. Put them in there. Add fuel. That. Let's take these torches. Crap torch. No, don't sleep. God, I'm getting some crap torches. Alright, the hypothermia is healed. Let's take this. Let's drink this. Take this. Let's go ahead and take a torch. Oh. Ahead and put that out, please. That one can stay there. And let's go. So we should be warm, and as long as the weather holds, it's not a far walk. I think we're gonna head up to, oh, okay, well. So much for all those torches. Head up to the forestry lookout. I'm gonna take the high side here, make sure that we have some visual on any potential wolves. If there's no wolves and things seem clear, we'll head up to the forestry lookout and see if we could find the heavy hammer. That's where I found it last time. And see what else is there to loot. And I'll probably call it an episode there. The next time we'll head back down. Dependent on if we find the heavy hammer or not, we will beeline it over to Spence's farm in Muskeg, or we will maybe do the dam. Grab these sticks. Yep, there's that one and that one. Grab all these sticks here. Keeping my eyes peeled. Don't see anything. I always forget the proper way to get up here. I think you're supposed to go down and around. think I always end up going in here and then up and around this way. I usually break a leg or two before I figure out how to get up there. I usually walk this way. And then somewhere around here, I try to force my way up here and break something. See, I'm red. It's red. It's always red for me. It annoys me to no end. Okay, red's gone. And it's back, and it's gone. It's back, and it's gone. Is that the trick? Just walk till it go and then stop? Hmm. Okay. Yeah, it is. You go up this way. You're despondent. Alright. Cool. Let's see. A couple rocks there. We have plenty of rocks. We got four. Yeah, we don't need more than that. I usually keep like 2 to 3 on me. Head up this way. How do you... Now what I need to figure out is how to hunt the predators. I guess for the wolves you wanna... I guess for the wolves you wanna drop like a torch and then shoot them in the face. The bears are scary because I know you can loop them, but I don't know how to do that. And if I get this bow and I try to loop a bear and he mauls the hell out of me, I'm gonna be really upset. And same with the moose. I know you can kind of like kite him, but I don't want to die. It might be something I need to fire up like a Voyager run and just practice. But then kind of defeats the purpose of like learning on Interloper. I don't know. Either way, we're here at the forestry lookout. Hey, our condition actually dropped quite a bit. Oh, it's because I haven't eaten. That's part of it. We can start a fire up here if we need to. And what do we got in here? Alright, simple tools. Fair enough. I'm not going to leave those up here. Take another cooking skillet. Another fire starting book. And sewing kit. No heavy hammer, unfortunately. That stinks. Another sewing kit. And some sardines, which I never look at the condition of, and I really should. Yeah, that's a bummer. I was hoping for the heavy hammer. So we could go to Muskeg. There may even be one at Muskeg. What's it feel like in here? It is 31 or hungry. What to do? What to do? How much time do we have? Still day. What's our inventory look like? We're overweight. I do not need 5, 4. Oh, I should drop this book off too. Fire starting and cooking. Okay. I guess. Yeah, I'm gonna actually call it a part here. We're gonna probably end up spending the night here. I think I will start a fire. Do I have any charcoal on me? I don't. I think I have a lot of fire supplies up here. With us, 2 wood, 10 sticks. No. As much as I'd like to, this place is gonna get cold in the middle of the night. And, are any of these warm? No. I'm thinking I start a fire and head back down. Yeah, I'm gonna do it. I don't want to push my condition too far. I'm gonna start a fire. We're gonna use our first match. I'm gonna start a fire up here. And then I'll work my way back down and just make sure that we can get back to the camp office. And the next time we will, I guess, head to the dam and those areas to see what's in store over there and what tools they have for us. That out. And I got a little fire icon. Go ahead and just do a couple. I just want to get enough going where I can just heat up these teas and warm up a little bit. Am I cooked up there? Ah. Can do that. That's cool. And let's see what else we got. Can I cook this right on the floor? Does that heat up? No? I'm gonna watch that. I don't think that heats up. Wait, can I put this on the floor? Can I put this on the floor and then use that brand new cooking pot I just got? Skillet. Then can I take this and stick that in there? No. Take it and can I cook it? Why can't I heat up a potato? Tell me? Tell me why. Doesn't make sense to me. Same thing with the, the hell is the thing called? The oats. You can't reheat the oats once you've made them. I'm gonna take that. I'm gonna drink this. Reishis are easier to come by than rose hips. Feel. And I guess we'll take another torch and bye. All right, we're warming up. Open the door. Let's get out of here. Well, that's cool. So, we managed to spawn in Muskeg, loot the train car, make our way over to Trappers, loot Trappers, find a mag lens, make our way to the camp office, loot the camp office, loot the lake, and loot the hell, the forestry lookout, all in one part. That's pretty good, I think. We're basically like speed running. We're like speed running the Long Dark right now. Seeing if I can jump down there. But yeah, we can. I think next time we'll hit the rest of the train. The broken down bits in. Broken down bits here in Mystery Lake. We'll definitely hit the dam and see. The dam will probably take a good chunk of time, but we'll loot through there. And then, yeah, I think dependent on what we find in the dam, we'll kind of determine where we go next. I really would love to just beeline it to Muskeg. I don't want to run down there because that's where I'm going to break some bones. I do really want to just beeline it to Muskeg if I could. What do I do? It's in here. I'm going to drop it. Light this torch up. If you do it the way I just did it, it lights up. It allows you to take the weakest torch. If you take it out of the radial dial, it's going to take the best torch you have to light first. And I usually don't care that much. But the more that we the more we use the radio dial, the best torches end up getting burnt, and then we're left carrying these like crappy torches. And the torches all weigh the same, whether it's 100% condition or it's, you know, 3% condition. So getting rid of it like a 6 or 7% torch is ideal, because it's going to cut the weight down for us. Now, what's that? Is that a stone? Yes. I'd like to grab a few more sticks while I'm out here. Especially while I have the warming up. So, again, we want to go here and, like, we'll grab the 20%. We'll light it. Versus, if I use that radio dial, it will use our best torch. There's a bunch of sticks here. Grab them quick. Alright. And I got sprain affliction, which means we're tired. And probably a bit overweight. Eyes for backpack. Yeah, we're just slightly overweight. It's fine. I want to stock up on sticks as much as we can. Is that a wolf? No, it's a deer. It's like, what is that? It looks like a wolf got an arrow in his leg. But it's a deer with some antlers. And we're heading back to camp office. And that's where we're definitely going to call it a part. I know I've said a couple times, we'll call it a part here, we'll call it a part there. But I think that's going to do it. Going to head back. Let me drop this, and I'm just going to, in an effort to be fast, see how it grabbed the 38% torch. So, yep, keep that in mind if you're, you know, you're giving the game a shot. Easy way to burn through your best torches. But that's going to do it for me, guys. If you liked the video, drop a like. It helps me out very, very much. If you are interested in more Long Dark content, please consider subscribing. And I will see you guys in the next one. Bye, guys.